testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'ma touch the sky. Gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'ma touch the sky.
Welcome to our February edition of A Clear View. I'm Marissa Borelli.
And I'm Brooke McGuigan.
This monthly show is produced at Clearview Regional High School. The students who produce this content are enrolled in the School of Media Arts, and these pieces are created in the television and video production class.
Starting off, you are going to see what it would be like if you switched lives with your polar opposite frenemy. Shout out Lindsay Lohan! You'll also be seeing how a pandemic affected our high school football team. But before I get ahead of myself, let's get this show started.
First up, Katya Palacio, Avery Goronsky, and I give you Wacky Wednesday.
Broken. You hurt my knee and I have a playoff game today.
Oh, I'm sorry. This boost is really expensive and I wanted to...
Just shut up. You don't understand what it's like to be an athlete. You never understand.
You couldn't even read at a first grade level, let alone read music. Being a musician is so much harder. I had such places with you any day.
Marissa, what is happening?
You're asking me. Do we switch bodies or something? I don't understand what's happening.
Obviously. And by the way, your room's really cute.
Please stop talking. This is serious. How are we gonna fix this?
Just meet me in the parking lot before first period.
About time.
Listen, I don't think we have any other choice but to just go through today as it is. And we could just lay low in school. It'll be fine.
Ugh, I just want to be me.
Hey, wait up! Hey.
Sorry I said playing a sport was hard. I had no idea. You're definitely not stupid.
No, it's all good. Playing an instrument is harder than I thought, too.
I can never do what you do.
Wow. I hope that never happens to me.
But it literally just did. Anyways, the past 2 years have been tough on everyone, and sports teams are no exception. Let's take a look at how the Clearview High School football team persevered and thrived during the pandemic. Aiden Dick, Emma Dykus, and John Sylvester give us the story.
Football games are one of, if not the most popular events at Clearview, with stands packed with fans. However, due to COVID last year, games were much more sedate. Senior football player Aiden McCullough elaborates on this.
Well, mentally, it was a little draining. I mean, it sucked. Like, all the guys, we didn't have a season, you know, how you're supposed to feel. But, I mean, we're ready for this season now.
All of society was affected by the pandemic, but the culture of sports teams took an especially big hit. Clearview head coach Steve Scanlon tells us more.
Some of the normal routines are just even down to locker room usage, how you practice, in what groups or units are practicing together, separation of players, separation of coaches. spaces amongst coaching and players. It was a large interaction thing that you wouldn't really think about, but then had to be conscious of at all times.
After only playing 3 games last year, the team left the season feeling low. But this year, with the stands full of screaming fans, it's a different story.
When we're walking down, and I'll be looking up and see people scream at us. And once we run in and looking up at the crowd, that's the first thing I look at. It's just a whole different atmosphere.
Aiden is only one of many football players deeply impacted by the lost season. Another aspect of Clearview football impacted by this was the coaching staff. Not only was precious coaching time lost, but weeks and weeks of dedication from both players and coaches was wasted. Head coach Steve Scanlon tells us about this.
Kind of helped me with things with perspective and being able to try to remain positive and just continue to focus on, all right, if we can give nothing else here, what can we make sure that our players are having a memorable, positive experience? So keeping that as a focal point has been really good moving forward.
Mr. Scanlon and his coaching staff have worked very hard to not only allow our players to continue playing, but also ensuring the safety of the team and school. Football games are a big part of Clearview, and both students and players are excited to see it back. This has been Emma Dykus, John Sylvester, and Aiden Dick reporting for Clearview High School.
It's all about that pioneer perseverance, am I right? Hey Marissa, have you ever wondered how to really cook?
Actually, I was just thinking about it. Since we're all going to college next year, I think it's important that we learn how to make quick, yet gourmet meals, like chicken and cookies. Shout out Ben Nolan, Mario Leone, and Connor Regan for giving us a comedic step-by-step how-to.
Hey, I'm Ben.
Hey, I'm Connor.
And our audio clip went to... So instead, we're doing this voiceover. Today, we're going to be making cookies and chicken.
If you want to make some really good cookies and chicken, follow these steps.
Woo!
You guys are going to need one egg. Mayor, hit me!
God.
What else we need, Ben?
3/4 cups of sugar.
Next, we're going to need 3/4 cup of brown sugar.
1 cup of salted butter. Oh.
1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. Now this is one of the most important ingredients. This is what makes your cookies delicious. What are we gonna need, Ben?
2 cups of chocolate chips.
Preheat your oven to 375 degrees. All right, you're gonna wanna get your bowl. Flour.
Baking soda.
Salt.
Not yet.
Once you have what is this called?
A bowl.
Once you have your bowl of stuff, you wanna take your butter, throw it in there, start whisking, fellas.
Whisk like your life depends on it.
Keep.
Hold on.
Add sugar.
Egg? Put it in.
Brown sugar?
What do I do with
put that back? Put that in. Add chocolate chips. Now this is where your cookies get fantastic, ladies and gentlemen. This brings out the flavor.
Mix them again.
This is why they're the best cookies in the world. All right, once you're finished mixing all your ingredients, you're gonna get something like that. Looks really good.
Cookie dough.
You're gonna need 1 sheet of parchment paper. On. Cookie dough.
We're not gonna make 10 small cookies. We're gonna do it the real way, the tough way, the manly way. 1 big cookie.
Man's cookie. You're gonna wanna make it in a cookie shape. Pretty circle, big cookie.
Now, if it doesn't come out perfectly like the circle, that's okay. It's gonna spread out and flatten out a little bit in the oven anyway. This is gonna be yummy.
Now, bake time!
Now be real careful with this. You don't wanna burn your hands in the oven.
Oh my God. Put it in!
Now we wait. So, our cookie's done, right? It's gonna be amazing. Look at this.
Oh my God.
Now, We're culinary experts. We do an abundance of things. Not only make cookies, but
chicken.
Chicken. First thing you want to season your chicken? Old Bay.
The good stuff. Oh, that's enough. The rest of the stuff doesn't really matter as long as you have Old Bay, so we're just gonna put it to the side right now. Put some more of that on there.
Matter of fact.
Alrighty, that's a lot. Okay, so for now you're gonna wanna have your chicken look like this. Shut up!
What?
Salt.
Old Bay.
Garlic powder.
Now, you never go wrong with the Old Bay. A little bit more Old Bay.
Okay. Montreal chicken
seasoning. Old Bay.
And then some garlic powder.
And your garlic powder.
And some more Old Bay. Now you're gonna wanna take the chicken and put it in the microwave. Now we're gonna put it in the microwave and put it in for a minute, 30 seconds. All right, it's done. Now let's take a look.
Oh!
Now that is some high quality chicken. We'll have our taste testers trying our high quality chicken.
How is it?
Out of 10?
Homemade.
I can't eat this.
Perfect.
What would you give it out of 10?
Perfect. 10. 10 out of 10.
Woo!
Yeah.
10 out of 10?
Mm-hmm.
Love to hear it.
Antone?
Not on the scale.
Oh. Liam?
Is this even chicken?
Yeah. We made it homemade.
Gonna have to ask you guys to leave.
All right.
Get out.
Get out. Get
some great
dessert.
Great guests. Giant cookie for you men.
Everybody, eat up.
Mmm.
So, fellas, how's the cookie?
It's good.
Great. So good and tasty, dude.
What would you guys give it out of 10?
We'll give it out of 10. On the rat. Give me a beat, Meezy.
Hey.
Cookie's so good.
Hey.
Mmm. I'ma wear a hood.
Hey. So, what's the cookie out of 10?
I got 4.
That home-cooked chicken looked amazing.
I think I'll stick to the cookies, maybe. I wish they brought some for us.
It's okay. We could just make some. Kind of like how we can make our own scarecrow. Here's how to make an easy fall-themed decoration with things you could find in your own home. Alyssa Feliciani, Liv Centenary, and Ryan Horde are gonna teach us.
Today we will be showing you how to make your own homemade scarecrow. But before we begin, let me fill you in on the history of scarecrows and where they came from. The initial intention of scarecrows was to scare birds away from fields. They can be dated back to the ancient Greeks and Egyptians by placing statues of their gods in their fields. The Japanese used what they called a kubiko to scare their birds away, which was a wooden post with old rags and bells on it. In the Middle Ages, children would run through the fields and scare birds, until they were replaced by old clothes stuffed with hay after plagues. The scarecrow are not only used to scare birds away from fields, but also used as a decoration for fall. Now you know more about scarecrows, it's time to make one for yourself. First, let's make sure you have all the supplies you'll need. You will need a long sleeve shirt and a pair of pants, hay or leaves, string, and a sack for a head. You can also use a plastic trick-or-treating pumpkin. And also, any accessories you would like to put on it, like hats or gloves. The first step is to tie the ends of the pants and the shirt to make sure the stuffing stays in. Once they are tied together, you start stuffing the clothes with either hay or leaves. For an additional effect, you can have the straw stick out of the arms and the legs. Once the clothes are stuffed, you tie them together to make the body, using the string. Then, once you have the body, you secure your head to the body. You can place any other needed accessories to the scarecrow that you choose. Now that this is complete, it can be placed into a chair or tied to a post for the perfect fall decoration. And that's it! You now have the perfect decorative scarecrow for the fall season.
Now I know what I'm going to spend my day doing. In fact, next we're going to see how a senior at Clearview lives.
A lot of parents wonder what a modern day or modern high school life looks like for their kids. So Allie Irvine, Bella Penzone, and Brooke McGuigan are going to give us an insight on a typical high schooler's life.
Hey guys, it's Friday and I just got ready for school. Fit check.
Good morning everyone, we just arrived to school. So today we have a match against Gateway, and these are the same girls that I played in the Gloucester County Championship. And I also passed out the last time I played them, so hopefully I don't pass out again.
So we made it to school. I don't know if you can see, but I also got my Dunkin'. Always have to have coffee in the morning, because I mean, we're high school students. We would get tired. So I think my day is gonna go somewhat decent.
Okay guys, so we're in anatomy now, and today we are continuing our brain dissection.
And I was right, no quizzes or anything, which I'm so happy about. But I mean, today was an okay day.
To go outside for our match, and we're playing Gateway.
Mm-hmm. We're gonna win.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I just left school with Alex, and we are about to go to Dunkin'.
Of the soccer game. I don't know if you can see it, but I'm here to support my girls, you know, fan behavior. And so I got my Wawa, which I will be eating while watching the game.
Okay guys, so we're at the football game now, and who do you think will win? Do you think we're going to do good?
I obviously want us to win.
But yeah, Clearview's gonna win 21-0.
So Clearview won, and we went to Dippy's, and I got a large, and I did not finish it all. And so Haley ate out of it. So now I'm gonna go home and sleep.
I'm probably gonna be home for the rest of the night, cause what are you gonna do on a school night? Nothing.
Okay guys, so I just got home from the football game, and I feel like today was actually really good. Like, it was a really good day.
Alright, this is my last vlog of the day. I just completed my optional Delta Math assignment for my math quiz tomorrow. I've been doing homework all night.
My tennis match went really well. Even though it wasn't a shutout, it was still 6-0, 6-1, so I mean, pretty easy. And then that had me in a good mood, and then we went to the football game, even better mood because Clearview won. And then we went out for ice cream after, and now I just could just relax.
But you know, it's all good. Catching up on the homework, getting ahead. basically what I'm going to be doing all year, but, you know, why not start early? Have my two support systems next to me or in front of me. You know, supporting me with my math, and they know I could do it. But my day, honestly, as a whole recap, it was pretty good. So thanks for watching my day in the life.
I love that piece. It's so interesting to see how everyone's life is so different.
I know, right? It's cool that we can capture our high school memories in video and picture form.
Yeah. Going along with taking pictures, Ashley Carlson, Kaylee Murphy, are gonna give us a story about how Clearview captures all the lives of its students with the yearbook.
A major part of high school is going to events and having fun with your classmates. We'd all like to remember those memories later in life, and the main tool for that is the school yearbook. Yearbooks have been around for many years, and they capture some of the most exciting parts of high school. Yearbook advisor, Mr. Kaminsky.
The best part about yearbook is watching the memories come to life in one book, and I think it gives students more time to enjoy their time here at Clearview.
The best parts of the yearbook club vary. You can see through the eyes of a student why the yearbook is so fun to participate in. Sophomore Makai Deeds.
My favorite part about yearbook is that I get to go to sports events and matches and events around the school to take photos.
Being a part of the yearbook club is just as important for the staff as it is the students. The club helps students feel involved, and it shows through the work of the final product. Yearbook advisor, Mr. Kaminsky.
Head of the club, just to see students express themselves in ways that we don't usually see in the classroom. I think it's fun to be creative. It's fun to do things that contribute to the school that you don't see on a regular basis. People see the yearbook, the finished product. They don't see what goes into it.
We encourage more students at Clearview to join this club because it gives you advantages in attending sports and events. Sophomore Makai Deeds.
I think it's a fun activity to do. It helps the school out with putting the yearbook together, and the end product is amazing.
It's so nice to learn about the thought and work that goes into capturing high school memories.
You're so right. For our final piece to share, we save the best for last. Have you ever had that feeling that something was going to happen to you? Well, the last video production takes gut feeling to the next level. Or a hall pass, created by Adam Rain, Brady Allen, and Jacob Stiles, this is Forewarned.
Give this to your teacher.
You're late. Now take out your notebooks.
Oh, man.
Oh, sorry.
Gee, thanks a lot.
Said I was sorry.
I got it. It's fine.
Thank you.
Seriously?
I'm out of it.
Excuse me, what are you doing? I thought so. Go to the office.
Jake, stop.
Ah!
What are you doing back there?
Brady made me staple my finger.
Brady, what are you looking at? There's nothing there.
That piece always gives me the chills. I think Brady deserves an Oscar for his great nonverbal acting. You're so right. Well, that's our show, and they're bound to get better. Don't forget that we'll be back later in the year with new episodes. Make sure you like, comment, and smash that subscribe.
Wrong channel. But anyways, be sure to stay tuned. Thanks for watching.